I'm not looking for superstar preachers. I'm looking for men that come out of the council chambers of eternity in the 1859 revival. In England, in Scotland, and in Ireland particularly, men came out of the fields with all the clay on their feet and whatnot, and they said that when they came in the sanctuary, some of them just stood and lifted up their Bible, and they preached, wherever the Bible opened, something they meditated on a day or two before, and they preached with more illumination and strength and wisdom than all the preachers in the country that time. Why? Because they had a direct line to the throne. The Spirit who inspired this word ignited it again. After all, he's the Spirit of God, he's the Spirit of fire. Our God is a consuming fire. And it's a cliche, but I'll say it again. The reason the world is going to hellfire tonight is the church has lost Holy Ghost fire. There isn't a person in this room ever seen revival. When the lights stay on week after week. And yet God brings a little black boy that could have it, couldn't speak English too well, and the Holy Ghost is on him, and what happened? Everywhere he went, he had revival. He died at 21 years of age. Why didn't God Almighty leave him in Africa? They needed him more than we need him. No, there were people here with big heads and shriveled hearts that needed to see a young man ignited with the power of God. And everywhere he went, in meetings, anywhere, teenagers would lay out under the power of God, groaning in conviction. It didn't take 6 months training. It took the finger of God. That's all he needed, once to touch him. But God bypassed them all. And he takes hold of a nobody, and not unanointed, unordained. Why are people so worried about being ordained? Won't do you any good. I don't know where my ordination certificate is. If I find it, I'll bring it for you next week. There's only one ordination, that's in John 15, isn't it? I have ordained you. I tell you what, if God lays his hands on you, everybody will know. It won't be known from here to yonder, it'll be known from here to hell. From here to hell. Preachers get angry when I tell them, if your name isn't listed in hell 5 feet high, it's time you got something from God. What did the demons say? Jesus we know and Paul we know. People ask me, have you any ambition? Well, I'm a young man, I should have. Sure, I have ambitions. I have an ambition to be known in hell. An ambition that the devil says, well, I don't know what Rainier's going to do today, but watch out, there's going to be some trouble around. Boy, wouldn't you like to be a troublemaker to the devil? What's the good of getting a degree in some theological seminary if you're no good to the devil? I read criticisms about the church. I don't take much notice of them. But when the Lord Jesus criticizes his church himself, boy, I'm all ears, I want to know. What does he say of the church? There's all kinds of interpretations about the last days. Pre-trib, post-trib, mid-trib, no-trib, so what? But I'll tell you what, most of the teachers are agreed, at least, that the day in which we're living is the day of the Laodicean church. Rich, increased in goods. Dear Lord, when did the church ever have the equipment that she has now? And yet she's dead and lifeless. Hell is filling. Dear God, if there's anybody that we should pray for in America today, it's preachers. They're preaching issue, drugs, divorce, this, and some of them need to be preached. I'm not arguing against it. I'm saying this. We need to preach about the blood. We need to preach about atonement. We need to preach about forgiveness. We need to preach about adoption. We need to preach about assurance. We need to preach about eternity. Dear God, we're going to live forever and ever and ever. I have a sign on my desk, some of you have seen it there, Lord, keep me eternity conscious. I don't think I need that. I wake up in the night, I think about eternity. Get out of bed and go in my office for a few hours. Meditate on eternity. Some like these boys now talking about success and prosperity. Well, why in God's name don't they take a plane and fly to Russia and preach it? Let them have a 6 months crusade there where they can't ask for a penny. Let them strut the mighty power of God they have. There's a lot of rotten hypocrisy in this whole thing. The church is piled up with it in this day. We need a cleansing, but judgment must begin at the house of God. When he was on earth, he cleansed the temple. If he came back now, he'd cleanse the pulpit, at least I hope he would. Maybe he'd cleanse it by bypassing it. So these men are going to sit down and say, where's that man get his authority? Where's that man get his wisdom? Jesus Christ has made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. And the knowledge of this world is dirt compared to the wisdom of God. God is going to vindicate his own holy name. He's going to raise up his men. Spirit born, spirit directed, spirit authorized, spirit energized. Because he's going to prepare a bride.